Hello and welcome to this review of some accessories for the Sony ZV1. I've got them for the ZV1 and I was sent these. The company got in contact with me and they sent them to me free of charge. I haven't paid for them. However, this review is my view. It's my review. The company doesn't get to see it before it goes out and I've not been paid for this review and I will be giving my full impartial view. Just a quick note, I'm Big G Video. I make videos about making explainer videos, video editing software, gear reviews, tutorials, and everything to do with video. So this is a mount for the Sony ZV1 that allows you to add extra things to it. So it's got a lens cap, which is really nice. It's got a lens hood, and it came with this very small Allen key. So all you do is you put it over the front of your ZV1, like so, and you tighten it up with the Allen key. Here goes. So I'm pretty happy with that. That's not coming off. And so if I just wanted to add a lens hood to my Sony ZV1, then yes, I could do that. This fits on like so. So if I open up my Sony ZV1, the lens comes out here and it just pushes out this 49mm ring. So this extension tube isn't really very good without something to put on it, unless you just wanted to put a lens hood on. So I was also sent this, and this is a wide angle and macro adapter. So again, we've got a lens cap. And so if I take that off, I can mount it onto the 49mm thread. And now I've got a wide angle adapter onto my Sony ZV1. Now the lens isn't taking the weight of the wide angle adapter is being taken by this mount here. So just the ZV1 on its widest setting with active stabilization. And you can see when we add the wide angle adapter, even with active stabilization on, it's much wider. Here we've just got the ZV1, no stabilization. And here we've got no stabilization on the ZV1 and the wide angle adapter added on. So if I take the wide angle adapter off, then this part here functions as a macro lens for the ZV1. So with the macro adapter, I could look at this bug on the window and record it. So this is at its most telephoto with the adapter on. Now I've set up just some lights on my ZV1 and a few household items. Here's my DJI Osmo. This is the wide setting without an adapter on. And this is as good as I can get really in terms of macro capability. Now if I do some telephoto and I really zoom in, I can't really get much better just with the native ZV1. Let's have a look. So this is about the best I can get with the ZV1 in telephoto. Not particularly good. Now I'm screwing on the macro adapter. And here you can see in wide, I can get a much better close-up image. That's really quite sharp. I'm really quite pleased with that. And then in telephoto, I can get much closer to the action and get much greater magnification. This is standard Lego brick, and you can see I can even see the word Lego in there when I use the macro adapter. This is my Loom Cube Air, and I can magnify the text pretty well, and I can even record the text on an ND filter for a very small action cam. So let's talk conclusions. This kit makes the ZV1 better than it was. It allows you to put a lens hood on the ZV1 and it allows you to have a macro lens on the ZV1 and make the focal length wider at the wide end. To me, those are all good things, and they don't compromise the ZV1, because you can take the extension tube off and the ZV1 still remains pocketable. So I think this is a great piece of kit. Thank you. Goodbye.